The announcement from the party came even before the official one was made, declaring Claudia Sheinbaum as the next president of Mexico. Sheinbaum's win is a landslide, and the winning percentage is expected to be the highest in Mexico's history. This was always going to be a historic election, with Mexicans heading into polling booths that showed a woman was expected to take charge of the highest office in the country. For weeks before the election, leftist Claudia Sheinbaum, who belongs to the same party as President Obrador, was leading polls ahead of her closest rival, also a woman, Xochitl Galvez. Sheinbaum counts the current President Obrador among her key supporters and political mentor, and belongs to the left-leaning Morena party, and she's benefited from Obrador's backing. President Obrador congratulated Sheinbaum and the people of Mexico on the historic win.
Agradezco también porque por primera vez en 200 años de la República me convertiré en la primera mujer presidenta de México. Nuestro gobierno será honesto, sin influyentismo, sin corrupción ni impunidad. Será un gobierno con austeridad republicana, disciplina financiera y fiscal y de autonomía del Banco de México. No habrá aumentos reales a los combustibles ni a la electricidad. Mantendremos la obligada división entre el poder económico y el poder político.
Sheinbaum's election is a big win for women in a country where women were not even allowed to vote till 1953. The former mayor of Mexico City, Sheinbaum comes from a family of Jewish heritage and is a climate scientist. In 2007, she also contributed to a report on climate change that went on to win the Nobel Peace Prize. Her critics have labeled her a puppet of President Obrador. Mexico's current president could not seek another term in office. In Mexico, the president's term is limited to 1 6-year term in office.
Porque tengo la esperanza de que todos nos levantemos el día de hoy a votar por un México libre, sin violencia, en paz y amor y amparados por la Virgen de Guadalupe.
Sheinbaum's task is cut out for her. This has been the most bloody election on record in Mexico's modern history. As many as 38 candidates have been assassinated in the run-up to polling day. Two people were killed at polling stations in Puebla state on voting day. The issue of violent crime has emerged as one of the top in this year's presidential contest, in which the ruling party of outgoing president has been forced to defend a persistently high murder rate, as the opposition had sought to use the bloodshed to argue for change. Relations with the United States will also be closely watched as Mexico's neighbor heads into elections in November. For more such videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Make sure you hit the like button and follow for more news updates.